Vital Auto is an industrial design studio with deep pockets of expertise in automotive design. We work with every major OEM. That includes the likes of Geely, Tata, Nissan, Volvo, Lotus, McLaren. And the work is to bring their high fidelity prototypes to various contexts that they want to use them in the shortest amount of time possible. Clients typically come to us to try and push the boundaries of what's possible with the technology available. They don't have time for experimentation themselves, but they can rely on us to bring about all the different elements that go into creating the exact tool that they require to do the job. It's very process and product agnostic as well in many ways. You know, we're looking at making things that could live in the virtual world as much as they do in the physical world.
We'll take a design anywhere from an already designed vehicle, from just simply a sketch on a piece of paper. We will design all the main frames, all the exteriors, interiors, open closings, pretty much whatever the customer needs on his vehicle. A typical show car can go through many design iterations. So sometimes we will have one or two iterations, sometimes we will have 10 or 12 iterations. Within those iterations can be further iterations of smaller components. Most of our customers will come to us with a new idea, an innovative idea, and something that's never been done before. So the challenges for us are new every single day, and they're endless. Much of the time, traditional processes are just no good for producing those parts. That's why we then started to look at 3D printing.
When we engage with a new customer, the initial sales inquiry is just the first part in the journey. So we need to make sure that we're set up to fully support that customer on new applications that they might want to be taking on in the future, and then also how they are going to be looking to scale up production to meet the full requirement of their customer base.
Today, we have a whole 3D printing department. We have large format FDMs, Formlabs 3Ls, we have a Form 2, and we have Fuse ones. In terms of capacity on all those printers, pretty much since day one, they've ran 100% 24/7. We use these printers for all areas of our concepts and designs. Typically, we would use the Fuse for our production-based parts, and we would use our 3Ls for our concept-based parts. We use Formlabs 3L machines for anything that is an A-class finished surface. So typically in an automotive environment, in an interior, where you have parts that are not being trimmed with leather or Alcantara or some sort of cloth material. Formlabs materials give us a nice smooth finish for our painters to work with. The thing that interests me most about Formlabs 3L machines is their versatility. The ability to do a material change in less than 5 minutes, and the variability of those materials going from a soft, flexible material to a machine-hardened, rigid material, for us is priceless. With the 3L, that allows us to produce multiple iterations of parts within, most of the time, less than 24 hours. We ended up buying three different machines so we could produce for our customers up to three different iterations of part at the same time. And we could also achieve this in three different materials as well. Formlabs 3L has allowed us to produce much more complex parts that typically we would never have been able to produce. Even with techniques such as 7-axis CNC machining, this would come at a huge compromising cost. The 3L negates all of that. It allows us to produce complex geometry very, very quickly and very cost effective. Fuse 1 was our first venture into SLS technology. This is a technology we thought we would never be able to have on site. What these machines enable us to do is produce structural and mechanical parts very, very quickly, not only for testing, but for physical applications of most of our concepts. For example, door hinges, door handle inners, anything that has to bear a structural load. The reason we do this is because straight off the printer, we can apply them to the job. They require almost zero to no finishing at all. Typically, when we would outsource or machine in-house CNC parts, we would have to wait 2, 3, 4 days to get the parts in our hands. The Fuse 1 enables us to have hands-on parts, in most instances, less than 24 hours. A lot of people think that additive manufacturing is here to replace subtractive manufacturing. We don't think that. We use the two together to help support each other. So we have many parts where we would use subtractive manufacturing and then have additive manufacturing to produce all the finer details. This allows us to have a much more cost-effective way of producing a lot of our concept models.
One of the beauties of using additive manufacturing is the compression of a time frame. So what do you do in that sort of span of time that you have freed up We sort of see it as extending the possibility space into imagining alternatives, adding more iteration loops in the process. Things that would have traditionally taken a lot longer are being compressed, and so are the demands on us as well to make some of the things that we are putting out there more salient to the people who are evaluating those properties.
The progression in technology and 3D printing over the last sort of 10 years is phenomenal. When I first started producing low volume niche vehicles, some of the products that we produce today would simply have been inaccessible compared to what I'm able to produce today. And not only am I able to produce these parts today, I'm able to produce them very cost effectively, very quickly.
There are certain things that you just can't class as emerging technologies anymore. 3D printing is one of those things. You know, it's advanced to a point where everything that we produce is good enough for use in the final presentation stage with all the layers of making that we apply on top of that. 3D printing has gone from almost a novelty to becoming an absolutely inseparable part of what we do.